Hi, I'm Flor Castillo. Welcome back to Tell It Like It Is. On October 1st, a gunman opened fire on a country music festival in Las Vegas from his hotel room overlooking the concert. The shooting was the deadliest in modern U.S. history, leaving about 59 people dead and more than 520 injured. Since the shooting, many politicians and outside groups have advocated taking a new look at U.S. gun control laws. This week on Tell It Like It Is, we're taking a look into our own state's gun laws. In 2014, Massachusetts lawmakers overhauled the state's gun laws and decided to make gun regulations stricter to gun buyers by tightening up background checks. But despite the efforts of Massachusetts lawmakers to stiffen firearm laws and curb gun violence, many argue that these laws aren't enough on their own.
I think Massachusetts is one of the more stricter. We have more stringent gun laws requiring certain things for licensure, as well as what you can and cannot possess legally as a citizen.
Consequently, deadly mass shootings have prompted national discussions about gun control, mental health, and the possible legislative efforts to prevent future massacres.
So I'm for people being able to possess firearms. You know, I wish there was a fix-all to these mass shootings, but there's always someone who's going to find their way around it. You know, the guy in Las Vegas had zero criminal record, passed all the background checks in multiple states to buy all the firearms that he had. I don't know how you stop that. You know, I wish there was, because if there was, then there wouldn't be this many people hurting. People with mental illnesses or mental disabilities shouldn't be able to possess firearms, but there's no way you're going to know that unless you get their medical records. And federal law, the HIPAA Act, prohibits you from seeing their medical records. So There's all of these catches.
Some changes sought by Democrats include universal background checks before purchasing a gun and banning bump stocks. Last week, both the Massachusetts House and the Senate voted in favor of a ban on bump stocks, and the governor, Charlie Baker, has said he will sign the bill.
The bump stock makes it a semi-automatic, which you pull the trigger once, one bullet comes out. The bump stock makes it so that you technically, your whole hand moves, pulling the trigger every time, but it makes it a fully automatic weapon. They're looking at outlawing that, which I can totally support because, like I said, there's no reason to have that.
Even though Massachusetts ranks number 3 in the nation for the toughest states for gun owners, according to Boston Globe, many argue the laws are still ineffective in curbing gun violence, and many organizations are determined to keep taking on gun control in the state. I'm Flor Castillo. Thanks for watching Tell It Like It Is.